Welcome to Arya College of Engineering and Information Technology, Cookers Chap. I am Harish Chawla from Department of Civil Engineering. We are going to discuss our new chapter, Surveying. Objective of Surveying. Surveying is the technique, profession and science of determining the relative position of various points and the distance and the angle between them. It is used in transport, communication, mapping and marking boundaries, etc. It is conceptual but requires skill and practice for higher accuracy. The relative position between two points can be determined by first one is horizontal distance and the angle between the two points. Second is vertical distance and angle between two points. Surveying works with the elements of geometry, trigonometry, physics, engineering and metrology, law and programming language. They use equipment such as total station GPS, digital level drones. Land surveying is the details study and inspection by gathering information through observation, field measurements, research of legal instruments and data analysis in support of planning, design and establishing of properties boundaries. The planning and execution of almost every civil engineering projects requires surveying. Thus, the objects of surveying are to take measurements to determine the relative position of points situated above on the or below the ground, to locate the point on the ground from the plans or maps, check the accuracy of layout plans, build up structures, etc. Prepare the plan and map required for various activities. Collect and record data on the relative position of points on the surface of Earth. Uses of surveying. Topographical maps showing hills, rivers, towns, villages, forests, etc. are prepared by the surveying. For planning and estimating new engineering projects like water supply, irrigation schemes, mines, roads, bridges, transmissions, lines, etc. surveying is required to determine different strata of the earth crust. Geological surveying are used for exploring minerals. Wealth mine surveying is used. Linear measurements. In engineering surveying, the linear horizontal distance is to be measured to complete a surveying. The measurement of this linear horizontal distance between two points on the earth surface is known as linear measurement. Linear measurement can be achieved by various instruments. The measurement type can be divided as direct measurement method, optical measurement method and electronic measurement method, depending on the type of instrument that is used to measure the distance. Direct measurement. A chain or tape is used for linear measurement in surveying. For general precision work, a chain is used while the tape is used for higher precision work. Chain are made of straight links of galvanized mild steel wires bent into rings and connected by small circular rings. In India, metric chains are widely used. Metric chains are available in 5 meter, 10 meter, 20 meter, 30 meter length, but the most common is 30 meter with 150 links and 20 meter with 100 links. They are made from galvanized mild steel wires of 4 mm. The end of each link is bent into loops and connected together by means of 3 oval rings, which provide flexibility to the chain. Metallic tacks or tallies are used at 5, 10, 15, 20 or 25 meter interval in 20 meter and 30 meter chain, and at every meter in 5 meter chain and 20 meter chain for quick reading. Small brass rings are provided at every metric length except 5, 10, 15, 20 meter, etc. In length of the links, in distance between the center of two consecutive middle rings, all links are 0.2 meter except the end slings. They are smaller because the length of brass handle is included in 0.2 meter. Advantage of chains. Suitable for rough use, can be easily required on the field, can be read easily. Disadvantage of chain. Due to heavy weight, it sags when suspended in air. Its length varies due to shortening, lengthening of links. It is suitable for ordinary work only. If the chain is found to be long, it may be adjusted by closing the opening joints of ring or reshaping the elongated links or removing one or more circular rings and replacing the worn out rings. If the chain is found to be short, it may be adjusted by straightening the bent links or flattening the circular rings or replacing circular rings with bigger rings and inserting additional rings. The overall length of the chain shall be in following tolerance: 5 meter plus minus 3 mm, 10 meter chain plus minus 3 mm in 20 meter chain plus minus 5 mm in 30 meter chain plus minus 8 mm. There are some other chains in surveying. Few of them are engineering chain. It is 100 feet long, having 100 links of 1 foot each. At every 10 links, brass tacks are fastened. It is used to measure distance in feet and decimals. Gutter chain. It is 66 feet long with 100 links of 0.6 feet or 7.92 inches in length. The length of 66 feet is convenient because 100 square chains, 10 square chain are equal to 1 acre. Similarly, 10 gutter chain is equal to 1 furlong and 80 gutter chain is equal to 1 mile. Revenue chain is 33 feet long and has 16 links, measuring 21 by 16 feet in length. It is used in the cadastral survey. Band chain or steel band. It is attached to a long narrow blue steel strip of a uniform width of 12 to 16 mm and 0.3 to 0.6 mm thick. It is available in 20 meter and 30 meter length. The first and last link is subdivided into semi and mm. It is easy to handle due to its lightweight, but it can be break easily and difficulty to repair on site. Tapes. For high accuracy in linear measurement, tapes are generally used in surveying. Tapes are available in a variety of materials, length and weights. Tapes are classified as per the material used in their manufacturing and can be of following types: cloth or linen tape. These are closely woven linen and synthetic material, and it is varnished to resist the moisture. These are available in length of 10 meter, 20 meter, 25 meter and 30 meter, and it width of 12 to 15 mm. The disadvantage of linen tape including it is affected by moisture and gets shrunk. Its length gets altered by stretching. It is likely to twist and does not remain straight in strong winds. Metallic tape. It is a linen tape with brass and copper wires woven into it longitudinally to reduce stretching. It is varnished and hence the wires are not visible. These are available in length of 2, 5, 10, 20, 30 and 50 meter. These are light and flexible and do not break easily. Tapes of length 10, 20, 30 and 50 meter are provided with a metal ring at outer end. As it is reinforced with wires, all the defects of linen tapes are overcome. Steel tapes. They are made of steel and stainless steel strips and come in length of 1, 2, 10, 20, 30 and 50 meter with 6 to 10 mm width. And the end of the tape, a brass ring is attached, the outer end of which is zero point of the tape. It is moved accurately when then metallic tapes. They cannot be used on the ground with vegetation and weeds. Invar tape. These tapes are made of an alloy of nickel 36% and steel 64%, known as Invar. These tapes have a very low coefficient of thermal expansion, 0.122 into 10 to power minus 6 per degree Celsius. They are available in length of 30, 50, 100 meter and in a width of 6 mm. Advantage of Invar tape: high precision. Second, it is less affected by temperature changes when compared to other tapes. Disadvantage if Invar tapes: it is soft and so deform easily. It is requires much attention in handling. Thank you so much.